So molar mass and Avogadro's number are nothing more than conversion factors. So what we need to do is take one and set it up. For example, nitrogen gas, 28.02 grams per mole. And we want to write out the substance that we're talking about so we don't get confused later. And so this just means 1 mole of nitrogen gas molecules weigh 28.02 grams. We can also say for molar mass, 1 mole of nitrogen gas per 28.02 grams of N2, and we'll see how to tell when to use which coming up. Okay, and for Avogadro's number, we just take Avogadro's number, 6.022 times 10 to the 23rd, and it is a something, whatever it happens to be, items, particles, whatnot. We'll say particles, because it really could be anything, per 1 mole of those things. And so we could even simplify it and just say, hey, just call it whatever it is, okay? So it could be an atom, it could be a rabbit, it could be anything. The other way we could write it is 1 mole of A per Avogadro's number. Okay, per number of A. Okay, we can write it either way. And so this is just a conversion factor. All right? And because it's conversion factor, we can use dimensional analysis which just states that we recognize what units we're given and what we want at the end. So we're given and what we want to pick the right conversion factor. And the way we do that is we say that we have our given unit, we have some number in our given unit. We always want our conversion factor to have the given unit plus some number on bottom, and we want a new unit on top. Okay, and so we keep going as long as we need to get to our desired unit. Forgive my handwriting. And so the reason we do that is so we can cancel out top and bottom. Note how this is all, we could say given unit over one, okay, and set up just one big long fraction here where we multiply in the middle. Some people like to do that, okay, and then they eventually get done. So all these are just sequential fractions, and we can divide out like units and then divide out numbers that we get at the end. So we pick our conversion factor that we use based on what we're given. So let's do a couple of examples. What are we given? So how many nitrogen atoms are in 5 grams of nitrogen gas? So we are given 5.00 grams of N2. We've got to know that nitrogen is a diatomic molecule, okay? And then we've got to know that we've got to get rid of grams of nitrogen gas, so we put that on the bottom. So what do we have in our bag of tricks that gets us, that gives us grams of nitrogen gas? Well, it's the molar mass, 28.02 grams per 1 mole of N2. So the molar mass is our first conversion factor. All right, and then now that we've gotten rid of grams of nitrogen gas, we want to get rid of moles of nitrogen gas. And so we say, well, I want moles on the bottom. And what gives us moles? Well, what are we going for? We want to end up with a number of nitrogen atoms. All right, so we don't want to end up with grams, we want a number. So we have to use Avogadro's number. But it doesn't ask us for molecules of nitrogen. It asks us for nitrogen atoms. And so we have to do one final conversion factor that we're not given. two nitrogens per one N2 makes sense. Okay, it's just a common sense. So we can get rid of nitrogen. We can get rid of moles of N2 by canceling what's on the bottom. And so what we've got to do now is what's left over, and I'll come down here just because we have room. And so when we multiply everything out and divide everything out, we end up with a number, divide our numbers to get the number, to three significant figures, because we're limited to three by this number, the given number, 2.15 times 10 to the 23rd nitrogen atoms. Okay, and the only unit we're left with is nitrogen atoms, and the number is found by dividing out and multiplying by all the numbers in our fractions. Okay. About the next example, how many grams of carbon are in 5 times 10 to the 24 molecules of methane? And so if we have our given unit, methane, we know from our nomenclature is CH4, 5.00 times 10 to the 24 methane molecules. And we want to know how many grams of carbon. Well, we want carbon, so how many carbons per methane? One C atom per CH4 molecule. So we can cancel out CH4 molecules. And what do you know? It's the same thing. We have the same number, 5 times 10 to the 24. So that's not very much or very interesting. But then to get to grams, we have nothing that compares atoms to grams. So we've got to get in terms of moles first. But we know what our next unit should be. It should put C atoms on the bottom. And it should have moles on top. And so the only thing we can put then is 6.022. times 10 to the 23rd C atoms. So we'd use Avogadro's number. And then we want to get rid of atoms and get grams. Now we want to use the molar mass. We've gotten rid of atoms and we want to get rid of moles. What's on top must go on bottom in the next conversion factor. And so we know 12.01 grams of carbon for one mole of carbon. And when we multiply everything out, we get 99.7 to three significant figures grams of carbon atoms. Because after the final cancellation, moles cancels, and we're left with grams of carbon, and all the numbers divide out to 99.7.